Hi everyone, this is Dr. Susan Brown at Alkaline for Life and Better Bones. You know, I'm going to talk once more about vitamin D. 15 years ago, I said that the simplest thing they could do to enhance public health worldwide was to ensure vitamin D adequacy. And that was after I'd done a big research project on vitamin D. Now we see how true that is. Today, I'm going to report just three new findings. Every day, new findings come across my desk, but these three are interesting. One talks about the fact that they've learned that people who are deficient in vitamin D or have low levels of vitamin D are much more vulnerable to opioid addiction. And in fact, it was showed the pain relieving effects of vitamin D, the mood elevating effects of vitamin D, and people who were severely vitamin D deficient were 90% more likely to become addicted to opioids, and people who were moderately deficient were like 50% more likely to become addicted to opioids. Makes really good sense. Another reason to make sure you have that vitamin D level. We like a 50 to 70, even a 40 is okay, but get adequate vitamin D. The next research piece that came across my desk was kind of interesting. It was about hip replacements, and they looked at women who had to have, I mean to say knee replacements, that had problems with the knees because they were getting pain in the knees and arthritis. Those women, actually, the women with low vitamin D had a 67% increase in the need for knee replacement if they were 30 NG or lower. So again, we see that inflammation of the knees, of this tissue, of the joints is greatly affected by vitamin D. If you want to avoid knee replacement, another good idea is to get that vitamin D in line, that 50 to 60 level. The final piece of study that came across my desk was about COVID. Every day there's new research on COVID. A lot of them relate to vitamin D. And this was from the United Kingdom, where they looked at people who had to be hospitalized for COVID and people who didn't have to be hospitalized. And they found that those people with a low vitamin D level, those people who were deficient in vitamin D level, were 2.5 times more likely to have to end up in the hospital for vitamin D than people who had adequate vitamin D levels. Very soon at Alkaline for Life, we're going to have a home test kit that you can test your own vitamin D, but your doctor should be doing it. Ask your doctor to do it. Make sure you have a 50 to 60 level of vitamin D. You'll be better off for it. So if you're interested in vitamin D, you may be well interested in all of your bone health. And I'm asking you to join us now for the Love Your Bones, Love Your Life retreat. This is the educational 4-day online retreat where I teach you everything I've learned over the past 30 years. I'm going to show you the complete Better Bones, Better Body program. Save your seat now. It is going to be in September. A great opportunity, a very affordable way to know everything I know about bone health. I hope to see you there.